amongst those original fans here. But the wonderful thing about those original fans is they multiply like triples. You're the sons and daughters and grandchildren and nieces and nephews of the original fans. And so we not only have the next generation, but third and fourth generation Star Trek fans. So thank you all very much. This is an absolutely unimagined gift. But to be frank, last week I was very apprehensive about coming to Texas. You know what the news has been saying about you.
No.
And last Thursday, they said that I was in New York then. They said that Dallas is going to have a thunderstorm. We've been seeing all the storming that's been going on in the Houston area. It's really horrible what's happened there. In fact, Thursday morning they announced that five soldiers had died in the flooding there. They'd been swept away. So, we give our thoughts to their families that suffered that horrible loss. But with Dallas, when we arrived, the tarmac was bone dry. The sky was gray, but there was no evidence of rain. And then we saw, as we were driving in, some sprinkles on the windshield. But that was about it. And this morning was beautiful. Blue skies and puffy white cotton ball clouds. So this has been a wonderful visit. And as we begin this portion of it, it's wonderful to see this room filled with you guys, because when they said, I'm going on at 4:30, I thought everybody's gonna be gone. You know, the convention's winding down. But I guess I didn't know Texas Star Trek fans. You are dedicated, determined, and so impatient. There you are. And that's what's given us this 50-year journey. And what that did to me was it made me think back